sales reps spend around 21% of their day writing emails. That's more than 8 hours every week. I'm gonna show you how to reclaim that time using email templates and AI to actually get responses. Want to follow along? Click the link in the description below to get started with HubSpot. I'm Alex, and this is How to HubSpot. Let's get started by building some of these templates. What we'll want to do is head over to HubSpot here, and we will click Library in the main navigation, and then click Templates. This is like your template command center. Think of it as the place where all of the email templates that you create for your sales team can live. What we want to do to create a new one is click on Create Template, and then since we're making a new one, we will hit Select from Scratch. Before we write anything, let me share with you what makes a cold email template really work. The first thing is you need an engaging subject line, one that is short. I like to keep it around 45 characters and really engages the audience. I mean, think about it. Would you open this email? Next, you need a really clear value proposition. And finally, I think one of the things that really helps is providing something of value, a key resource, some information, something that gives them benefit just from opening that email. Now, let's create one. First, name your template something specific, like industry pain point outreach. Being specific here when you're creating all of these templates really helps when you're managing a library of them later. Now for the subject line, like I said, think about what would make you open this email. Something like prospect's company plus the company you work at. Maybe quick question about industry challenges. This works because it's specific, it's personalized, and I think because it's also relevant. So for the secret sauce, personalization. Click on this personalization dropdown right here to add some personalization tokens. So you've got a lot of options here. You can do first name, industry, company name, and even custom properties that you've created. Inserting personalization tokens like this makes the personalization automatic, relevant, and easy by pulling in the information that is already available in your CRM. But here's my favorite trick. If you mix personalization tokens with spaces for manual personalization, let me show you. So if I type this email out, I might say, hi, first name. That's a personalization token. I noticed specific observation. That's a space for manual personalization. About your company and thought you might be interested in how we helped similar company achieve specific results. Those brackets serve as really good reminders. So right when I'm about to hit send, I can go in and personalize this email template with the information that I've found as I've been doing my research about this company. If I want to make the email a little bit more engaging, I'll click on the More button right here and do a couple things. First, let's add some bullet points for scanning. Maybe we'll want to bold a couple of the key benefits here. And finally, something that I think a lot of people forget is leaving some room for white space just to make the email easier to read. Also, before we send, we cannot forget, we have to have a clear CTA. If I click insert right here, I can add a bunch of different CTAs. So one thing I like to do are add sales documents. Those could be one pagers, they could be case studies about your product. You can also do things like add videos, add meeting links, and even snippets of frequently used text. So, one of the pro tips I have is to actually create a snippet for your signature or maybe common phrases that you kind of find yourself saying over and over again when you're talking about your product. If you don't know how to do that, let me show you really quick. So, if you don't have any snippets, click here and click Create Snippet to create some and save you some time. That's it. If we go back to our email here, all I will do is hit Save. And you're ready to go. Let's get these templates working for you. There's three main ways that you can actually access and send these templates. Let me show you. So first, you can come right over here to your CRM, and then we click Contact. Pull up this contact right here and just click on the email icon to email any contact. Now, this also works with lead records or with deal records, but for this example, I'll just use a contact. So we can pull up the template here and send. Couple other places we can use templates are in Gmail or Outlook, and we can also use them in automated sequences, which are some of those sales automation campaigns. Let's set up your email integration. So first, I will click Settings, then I will click Email and Connect Personal Email. What we'll do here is I'll just hit connect. Let me enter my email. And then I'll use Gmail as this example. One thing to note is this does work with Outlook, but I'll continue through here, click through these buttons, and connect my email. Just like that, you're connected. Now, what if I wanted to use HubSpot to send emails, but I work inside of Gmail and want to access everything from there? It's possible. We just have to install one quick extension. So let's head over to the Chrome extension store here, and we will search for HubSpot Sales. Here it is right here. And let's click Add to Chrome. Once this is installed, you'll have the little HubSpot orange button in your Gmail and be able to access everything HubSpot. So one click right here, if I pull up Gmail and pull up an email, is access to all of my templates. Now, quick tip about using templates if I'm about to send this. You always want to do a double check before you hit send. First, let's make sure those personalization tokens we added earlier have actually come through. Then remember, we added all of those manual spots to add some research we did about our customer, about the company. Let's make sure we actually added those in. And then finally, one thing I always like to do, just double check formatting. Make sure this email is easy to read. Let's go ahead and hit send here. Now the best part, HubSpot's gonna go in and we'll track everything about the email. I'll know how the open rate's doing, what the click-through rate is like, and even the deliverability. It's important to take a look at these to make sure I'm sending the most engaging emails and modify anything that might not be working. All right, let me show you something that's really cool. Let's head back to Gmail. So first, do you see this little breeze icon here in your email? Think of it as having a professional email writer on staff for you 24/7 to help you draft all those cold outreach emails and follow-ups. Let me show you what I mean. Click on the button, write an email for me, and let's write an email. Here's how it works. Right here, you're gonna be able to choose your email type. You can select from cold outreach if this is maybe the first time that you've talked to this person. You can send an introduction email if you maybe wanna tell them a bit more about yourself, about your company, about the product. And finally, you can also send a follow-up email. So you can have that. You also have the opportunity to add some context. Things like, what are you selling? What are the different pain points? What's your value proposition? And what are you trying to communicate? Finally, you also get to set your tone. I find that a combination of professional and helpful works really, really well for me. So let's build one. So first, I'll select cold outreach email here, and let's describe what we are selling. For this example, I'll say we're selling some giant oversized bean bags. I mean, who doesn't want one of those? We'll enter who we're selling it to, which is our target customer. In this case, that's going to be hotels and apartment buildings. Finally, we will describe what we want to communicate in this email, really giving it as much information as possible to write something that's relevant to your product and that your customers are going to care about. So I'll save us some time here and I will paste in some information about my beanbag company here. And then let's select the tone. Let's go professional and helpful, and then hit generate. From there, HubSpot is gonna work some magic and generate us a relevant cold email that's gonna tell these people all about our oversized beanbags, saving me tons of time and writing the email for me. A couple best practices here before we hit send. Now that it's generated the email, the last thing I want is a generic AI email going out to my customers. So let's take a look at what it generated and review it really quick. So first, let's make sure this output matches my voice, the style I'm going for, and is accurate to my product. I wanna make sure that the right details are included. You can see that here. And then I also wanna make sure that this is still personalized to the person I'm sending it to. Now that I've got this ready, I can hit send. And one last kind of key tip here is for any of those AI emails where it's generated it and you think, wow, that's like a great email. Go ahead and hit save and save those as a template. That way in the future, you're able to send some of those best performing emails and save yourself some time. Now you have everything you need to write better emails in a fraction of the time. Remember, good cold outreach emails include relevant personalization to show that you've done your research, clear value propositions about your company, about your product, action-oriented CTAs that drive the person towards an action, and use AI when you can to save yourself some time. Want to learn more? Check out the link in the description below. I'm Alex. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.